G'day, Sid. What brings you here?
Oh, you, of course, Elizabeth. Hello, Jim.
Hiya, Sid.
Now, what's all this I hear about you getting depressed?
Who told you?
Little bird.
Well, not exactly depressed. Just been thinking things over.
About what I asked you? And?
Well, I don't reckon you know what you're letting yourself in for, Sid. Asking an old lag like me to marry you. I mean, what are your friends think?
Elizabeth, if there's anyone in this world who doesn't like you, they're not my friends anyway. Besides, I've made decisions for myself for a number of years now, and I decided I want you to be my wife. So, only thing is, do you want to be?
Oh, yes, Sid, I do.
Well, then that's all that matters, then. Oh, sure, we won't be seeing too much of each other for the next few months, but that'll make each visit better, won't it? Yeah, I've got a little something for you. Hope you like it. The diamonds from my wife's engagement ring. But I had it reset for you.
Oh, Sid. That's beautiful.
We're going to be very happy, Elizabeth.
You bet.
Now, there is something fishy going on. I just don't know what it is.
Well, I'll keep my eyes open.
Good. I appreciate that, Terry. And by the way, if you want to ring me, it's a card.
Right.
Enough. Now go and do something, Lorna, until things calm down in here.
God.
Yeah, I think you better come over with
her. No! Oh, right! That does it.
You go and get B.
Now, we don't need B. We can look after this one ourselves.
Right, girls?
You are. See this? See this? Means you're no better than us. Just another pig in the pigsty. Just like us. And if you think you're special, well, you better watch yourself, because you're not. You're a bloody bitch. You're a bloody
Doreen.
Bitch.
Cut it out, Doreen, for crying. Hey, what's going on?
What the hell was that all about? Oh. That bloody bitch thinks she's too good for this joint.
Yeah, well, I gotta admit, she was asking for trouble.
And she got it.
Looks like that one's gonna have to learn the hard way.
Well, I should have thumped her.
Oh, gone straight to the pound. Use your head. She's the kind that go right to the screws.
Yeah, don't worry about it. She's just not worth it.
Well, I didn't reckon she was like that. I was feeling sorry for her.
Oh, yeah, she's a rotten, stuck-up bitch.
Let's forget it. It's all over.
Forget it? She reckons that we're all bloody animals.
Well, here's the fire brigade. What's the matter, Vera? Do you smell smoke? Which one of you attacked Paige?
Attacked Paige? We wouldn't dare.
Yeah, she's far too much of a lady, Miss Bennett. Do you know that she thinks she should be in an upper-class prison?
Oh, don't talk rubbish, Burns. There's no such place.
Oh, really? You mean I can't better myself?
Yeah, men only, eh?
Yeah, a bit of a change.
Yeah. You know, I keep hoping that one day we'll get served something different, something exciting. Or at least recognisable. What is it?
Chicken and prawn curry.
Oh, yuck.
Yeah, I'm not too keen on old chook myself.
Oh, I don't know. You've been out with a few?
Hey, steady on. Think of my reputation.
Yeah, talking about reputations, I noticed that you're pretty involved with the Hall case.
So?
So I was wondering why you're so keen.
Oh, call it old times. I was once pretty fond of her.
And that's all?
Yeah. I feel as if I should protect her.
Nice try, Terry, but I don't buy it.
Oh, come on, Jim. What do you think I'm up to?
I don't know, but anybody that gets a calling card from Inspector Grace is in deep trouble.
Oh, you saw that.
I keep my eyes open.
All right, there's something going on. Call it playing detective, if you like. I believe you did something like that once.
Yeah, but at least I knew what I was looking for. You haven't got a clue.
Yet.
I think you're being a bit hopeful, mate. If I was you, I'd just drop it.
Well, we'll see what happens, won't we? At least it gives me something to think about.
As long as that's all it does.
Mrs. Davidson asked for 3 copies, not 2. And could you please copy what's written and not make it up as you go along?
Morning, Vera.
Oh, Meg, you're working here today.
Well, part of it. I'm going to visit Alison Page's family later on this morning.
Page got herself into trouble with the other women last night.
Well, what happened?
Well, I don't really know. The women won't say. But in my opinion, she asked for it, putting on all those airs and graces. She's no different to the rest of them.
She is new, though.
And what difference does that make?
Well, it takes time to adjust.
If she lasts that long.
Good morning, ladies.
Ah, morning, Sid. Ah, you're looking very spry.
Never felt better in my life.
Are you here on business, Mr. Humphrey?
Oh, no. Just popped in to see Elizabeth. Got a lot to discuss.
You visited yesterday?
Yeah, that's right.
But you should know that it's 1 visit a week.
Oh, well, yeah.
Just a minute, Sid. I don't think Miss Bennett has heard the news.
What news?
Sid and Lizzie were engaged yesterday.
Engaged? But that... Well, that does make a difference. Could you contact the governor for me? Congratulations are in order. You must be very happy.
We certainly are. Thank you very much.
Oh, it'll be buns of having a wedding. Not like last time.
Why, what happened then?
Oh, bloody Blossom. Birdsworth got so full of his bucks tonight he couldn't stand up straight. His hand was shaking so much I had to put my own ring on.
Oh.
Well, I don't think I'll have that sort of trouble with Sid.
No, different as chalk from cheese.
My dear, the corridor is very crowded today. No room for ladies, is there?
Okay, ease up. But someone better get themselves sorted out. Or someone might have to do it for them.
Oh, do pardon me.
Birdsworth.
Oh, hello, Miss Bennett. You do look nice this morning.
That's enough of that. You've got a visitor.
Oh, another one. Gee, someone else is going to propose.
Too late. I'm engaged. Is it Sid?
I can't imagine who else it would be.
Oh, beauty!
Oh, talk about the blushing bride.
And Mrs. Davidson got in touch with Captain Burton. Yeah, what a nice man he is. He said he'd be only too pleased.
I wouldn't want to be married by anybody else. Oh, he was a real good sport, Captain Burton.
Now, Elizabeth, I want you to arrange with Mrs. Davidson to get your wedding dress. I'll leave some money with her.
What are you talking about? I've got me own money.
Have you?
Of course. Left over from me compo.
Oh, well, if you need anything, you let me know.
Oh, you are a good man, Sid.
Well, come off it, you've given me a big head. Yeah, listen, I've been thinking about the ceremony. It'd be nice if we had it outside.
Yeah, I've been inside long enough.
Yeah. Oh, now, just a place, a park. There's a fountain there and beautiful rose gardens.
Oh, and Bee and Dora and Jude and Lorna and... Oh, that's no good. If we get married outside, none of my friends will be able to be there. I mean, they're all in here.
Well, couldn't I let them out for the day?
I wouldn't like their chances. What do you reckon, Miss Bennett?
I think it most unlikely that Smith and the others would be allowed to attend a wedding outside.
Mm, I see.
So it'll have to be in the garden, just like Dora's wedding. Oh, that was a lovely day, though, wasn't it, Miss Bennett? What do you reckon?
Well, if that's what you'd like, Elizabeth, it's fine with me.
Of course. It won't be as romantic as a park with roses.
Oh, never you mind about that. We'll be married the way you want. Yeah, bit of a shame, though.
What do you mean?
Well, that there isn't time to clean up the garden. I could do wonders if I had a fortnight. The borders, perennials...
Now, listen. You're supposed to take things easy. You leave the garden as it is. I don't want to marry an old croc.
Yeah, all right. Oh, you got someone to give you away?
Yeah, I've got just the person. And you'll never guess who it is.
course you can be married in the garden, but are you sure about the other?
Yeah, real sure.
Well, Lizzie, I appreciate the offer, but I couldn't. It's a man's job. I've never heard of a woman giving the bride away. Wouldn't Mr. Fletcher do?
No. I want the governor, and for a special reason. When I get out of here, I hope to leave this prison for good.
Well, I hope so.
Yeah, well, if I've got Sid and house and everything, well, why would I want to come back to this dump?
What about the last time?
Oh, that was different. I was frightened of being alone then. I'll be okay with Sid. You know what I mean?
I think I understand.
Yeah, and if you give me away, that'll be like you setting me off on the right track.
All right, Lizzie, I'll give you away.
Oh, good on you. Can I ask one other favour?
What is it?
Well, Sid's gone all funny. He wants me to get a wedding dress. You know what men are like.
Well, you certainly should wear something special.
No, I'm too old for all that sort of thing, but I wouldn't mind looking, you know, elegant.
What did you have in mind?
I don't know. Could I get out some of me compo and have a half day to go and get something?
I'm sure that could be arranged. In fact, I'll take you myself.
Mrs. Davidson.
What about this afternoon?
Oh, you little ripper.
I'm Mrs. Morris from Community Welfare.
Of course, come in.
Well, actually, I think we've met before. I did the pre-sentence report on your wife on the last occasion.
Oh, yes, I thought I'd recognize it, but please sit down.
Oh, thank you.
I'm glad it's you helping her. I'm sure it was your report that kept Alison out last time.
Well, I'm afraid I won't be able to give her the same help this time.
I know. Have you seen her?
Yes, yesterday.
How's she going?
Oh, well, it's always difficult at first. It takes a few days to adjust. But I'm sure she'll settle in.
It's pretty hard thinking of her in there. Dreadful business. But I suppose you see it all the time. Part of your everyday work.
Well, basically, I'm a probation and a parole officer. But I also help with welfare work with Wentworth prisoners and their families.
I'm glad someone does. You feel so hopeless out here. One minute you have a nice, happy family, the next, pow.
How are the family coping?
Well, they've been terrific. I don't think they really noticed last time it happened, but when Alison was sentenced, it really hit home.
How old are the children?
Chris is 15 and Susan's 10.
Well, I hope their schoolmates don't hear about it. Kids can be pretty cruel at a time like this.
It's the one thing that worries me. The item in the newspaper.
On Alison? Mm.
Just one paragraph, but someone will read it. All the kids will know.
Yes, well, that's something all prisoners' families have to face.
I want my kids hurt as little as possible. It's out of our hands. We all love her. It's completely out of our hands now. There's nothing we can do to help her.
Did you pick the cleaning detail for D Block?
Hmm?
Well, did you or didn't you?
What's eating you?
Nothing.
Nothing? I hate to see you when there was something.
I don't have to be sweetness and light all the time, you know.
Oh, I noticed.
I just don't feel like being...
happy?
If you like.
It's Kathy, isn't it? Vera, I thought we'd been through this. Look, you know how I feel.
Right now, I don't care if you believe it or not. I'll tell you something else. Neither you nor Jim is going to stop me from finding out what's going on.
What's Jim got to do with it?
He tried to talk me out of it as well, but it's none of his business. Look, all these threats and attempts on Kathy's life, they're for real, and I'm going to find out who it is and why.
Well, at least there haven't been any more threats, have there?
Why, not yet, no.
Well, then it's probably all over.
Oh, don't you believe it. These people, whoever they are, have gone to a lot of trouble. They're not going to stop now.
And do you run your own business?
Oh, most plumbers do. Of course, you need someone to answer the phone and so on.
And that was Alison's job?
Most wives do. Oh, you've done pretty well out of it.
Yes, I can see that. done very well indeed.
We own the house and the car. Just paying off the van.
Bought the kids that stereo last year. Best on the market.
And how are you going to manage without Alison?
Good question. I'll have to ring at nights, I suppose. Probably lost a few jobs through it already.
Well, can't you employ someone?
No, it's not worth it. She won't be in that long.
Well, what are you going to do when she gets out?
Go on as before, I expect. I don't know. I still don't understand why she went off like that.
You mean the gambling?
Everything. Why she was unhappy. She had everything she wanted. At least I thought she did.
Have you been talking to her?
I did, a couple of years ago when she was first caught. She said she was sorry, but 12 months later she did it again.
Well, did you try counselling?
Oh, I didn't think she needed that. Well, I knew about the bingo and the TAB, but then I found she was going to the midweek races and losing hundreds. And it was too late. She'd pinched all those things. I don't know. I still don't understand. Maybe she's a bit off balance. Maybe she does need some kind of help.
Well, I think the best help you can give her at the moment is to visit her as often as possible. Make her feel needed.
She knows that we love her. There's no doubt about that. Whatever she's done, we're not going to turn our backs on her.
I'm glad, because some families do.
No way. We're going to visit her as often as possible. We're a family. We're going to stay together.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher. Sit down, Alison. I went out to your home today.
How are the kids?
Well, I only saw your husband, but I believe they're coping very well.
You can't imagine the worry. I keep thinking the most dreadful things might happen to them.
Well, you can relax. They're okay. But what does concern me is the fact that you're not coping very well in here.
But I can't stand it in here. I'm going to go mad.
Oh, I don't think so. But I do think you've got to learn to pull yourself together.
Can't you get me out? You did last time. I'll be good. I won't do it anymore.
Come on, Paige, control yourself.
Now, Alison, listen to me. You have got to accept the fact that you're going to be here for 3 months. Now, we've already discussed this.
But all those horrible women.
I think if you gave them a chance, you'd find that they're very friendly and quite easy to get on with.
But they're criminals.
Well, so are you. You've all committed a crime and been sentenced.
I'm not like them. I'm not dangerous.
Neither are they.
That's not true. I've heard them. They're going to get me.
And what makes you say that?
I just know, that's all. But you don't understand. Nobody does. Nobody cares what happens to me in this place.
All right, Paige, come on, that's enough.
You have no right to threaten me.
I'm not threatening you. But I think you better learn to cooperate. Now, come on, back to the laundry.
Do I have to?
Yes, you do. But there is nothing to be afraid of.
If something happens to me in there, I hope you feel guilty.
Hey, B, do you reckon Lizzie's going to have any bridesmaids?
I don't know. She hasn't said anything about it.
I'd like to be one.
Well, I'm sorry, love, but you can't.
Why not?
Because you've been married. You need to be matron of honour.
You mean I can't ever be a bridesmaid?
Never.
Huh?
Well, looks like I'm the only one here who qualifies.
Well, that's not fair. I've been cheated.
Oh, never mind, love. You'll make a lovely matron of honour. That's, of course, if Lizzie wants one.
Hey, listen.
Here comes the flying bride.
Mrs. O'Regan's going to make me a triple decker.
Wedding cake, you mean?
What else? Of course.
That's terrific, love.
I've never had such a wonderful time in my life.
All right, come on, how about a bit of work around here? Paige, you can work with Burns.
Hey, you coming to my wedding, love?
Why not? Everybody else.
Get away, don't touch me.
You bloody stuck up bitch.
Don't you talk to me like that.
She was only being friendly.
Get away.
I should smash her face in.
Oh, scream.
Oh, go on.
All right, what's going on?
Girl talk, Mr. Fletcher, you wouldn't understand.
Paige, I think you'd be better off on cleaning duty.
Thank you.
Ooh, thank you. My, aren't we polite?
Yeah, make sure you don't kick the bucket.
Watch it, Burns. And the rest of you, get back to work. Come on, move it. Come on, Paige.
He'll hold your hand if you ask him nicely.
Hey, you're sure scrubbing isn't too menial for you?
Why don't you get yourself a middle-class mop?
I'm sorry I asked you.
Ah, come on, forget her.
I tell you what, Julie, I'm getting fed up with the paperwork.
Nah, it's not like the good old days. Floggings. Thumb screws, the rack, huh? Yeah, in those days, work was fun.
Oh, Mr. Harrison, would you get Lizzie Birdsworth for me, please? We're going shopping for a wedding dress.
A white wedding?
No, I don't think so.
Ah. Julie, could you finish the paperwork for me, please?
Mr. Mrs. Davidson, have you got a minute?
Yes, I have, actually. I'm just waiting for Lizzie. We're going to buy a wedding outfit.
Hmm? Oh, yes, yes. Look, I'm very worried about Alison Page.
Well, let's talk about in my office, shall we? When Mr. Harrison comes back, would you get him to keep Lizzie here, please?
Yes, sir.
It's a bit hard on Sid, I suppose. He can't ask his mates, but he doesn't mind.
Who's coming?
Oh, his son, Gordon's his name.
Is he spunky?
Oh, I don't know. He's got a wife and two kids. Oh. All my mates are coming.
Bill, don't forget we're Sid's mates too.
Yeah, you don't own him, you know.
Everybody's coming.
Except that Paige bitch. I'm going to get her.
Dor, forget it.
She's not worth it.
Jude's right. She isn't worth the trouble.
There's a vacancy for a future bride in the governor's car when she's heading in for town. Anybody interested?
Hey, I better get ready. I won't be a tick, Mr. Harrison.
All right, come on, get back to work.
Well, a basic problem is that she can't or won't accept the situation.
I should have thought she'd have settled in by now.
She's having trouble relating to the others. Mind you, I think it's her own doing.
What do you suggest?
Well, I don't think there is much we can do except keep a watch on her.
Could Dr. Weissman help?
No, I wouldn't like to see that happen. In her state, it might encourage her to become more neurotic, which could only make things worse.
Well, what's the answer then?
I think she could see a lot more of her family.
She's applied for a family visit. Could make a difference. Let's hope so.
Well, when are they coming?
Tomorrow.
I've met her husband. He wants to visit her as much as he can and seems determined to support her.
Good. At least she has her family behind her then.
I've looked through all the magazines, but the new fashions wouldn't suit me. I reckon they're a bit daggy.
Yeah, I know what you mean. The brides are wearing some pretty funny things these days.
All the young ones do. Oh, I couldn't wear anything fancy like that. Well, I wouldn't mind some lace, maybe on me hat.
You ready, Lizzie?
Oh, you bet. Have you got me money, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes. Don't forget to sign off.
Oh, I'll have to start learning a new signature soon, won't I? Bye, all.
Goodbye, Lizzie.
How about this?
That's an extra large. I don't have it in a small.
Oh. We got anything in rose? I love rose.
It is a very fashionable colour this year. Oh, this one is lovely, Lizzie.
Oh. That's beautiful. That's just what I want. Can I try it on?
Of course.
What do you reckon, Mrs. Davidson?
It looks lovely, Lizzie.
You think Sid'll like it?
I'm sure he will.
Then I'll take it. I better have a bag and some shoes. Oh, and a hat.
What did you have in mind?
Well, let's have a look, shall we?
Try this one.
Are they plastic?
Hardly. Pigskin or genuine leather.
Oh, I'll take this one. No, that one. Oh, bugger it, I can't make up my mind. I better try on a hat. Wait to show B and Dor my new clobber. I reckon they'll love it.
You'll look lovely, Lizzie.
Mrs. M's gonna take the photos. I hope they're in colour.
They will be. That's $375 altogether.
Hey! Oh, I haven't got enough. What am I gonna do?
Oh, Lizzie,
it's just so lovely.
God, how'd you afford something as expensive as that?
Someone up there's looking after me.
Oh, yeah? Up where?
Old Davo.
You mean she bought it for you?
Nah, I took some of my own money, but I ran out, and so she made up the difference.
Well, what do you know? She does have a heart after all.
B, you should have seen that shop we went to. Old Davo buys some of her glad rags there, and the woman in the shop did nothing but sniff at me, but she practically licked Davo's boots.
Oh, real high class, eh?
Yeah. May I help you, madame?
Oh, yes. I would like a pair of overalls and gum boots. Oh, and earrings to match.
Oh, I just can't believe it. Old Elizabeth Birdsworth getting married.
Yeah, well, you better start believing, love, because it's about to happen any minute.
Oh, I wish Ellen and Josie could be here. I did write to them. I know they'll be pleased. Hey, you know what? I'm going to have two families now. Gordon and his wife and two kids and... Well, I suppose that's about all.
You don't want too many, love. You'll never remember all their birthdays.
B, I'm so happy I could burst.
Well, you go right ahead, love. We'll pick up the pieces.
How do I get into this place?
I beg your pardon?
How do I get in? You do work here, don't you?
Well, I think you go through to reception and they'll look after you.
I doubt it. Where is reception?
Bill? Through this gate, follow the path. I don't think you'll have any trouble. You are visiting one of the inmates, are you?
Yes, I am. Her name's Birdsworth and mine's Humphrey. Now, if there's nothing else, may I please go in?
That's all, Mr. Humphrey. Oh, you are Sid's son, aren't you? I'd like to talk to you about the wedding. Oh, unfortunately, I have work to do. There's another family arriving.
Would they have guns, Dad?
I don't know, mate. Wouldn't think so.
Daddy?
Yes, Donnie?
Is Mum in there?
Yes.
Come on.
Oh, hello, Mr. Page.
G'day. This is Chris and Susan.
Hi.
Mrs. Morris is, what would you say your job was?
Well, I suppose I'm a sort of social worker. I help people inside the prison and outside.
Including Mum?
Including your Mum.
How is she?
Oh, she's managing, but it takes a while to feel comfortable.
Can we see her?
Yes, of course. We have a visiting suite.
Paige, you've got visitors.
No. I thought they were coming this afternoon.
Don't you want to see them?
How can I face them? They're my kids, Miss Bennett, and look at me in this horrible uniform. What will they think of me?
You don't have to see them. You have the right to refuse.
No, I'm coming.
Well, come on then. I'm not waiting all day.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
But who is it?
You want to see me?
No, I came to see Elizabeth Birdsworth.
That's me. Who are you?
Humphrey. Gordon Humphrey.
Gordon? Oh, why didn't Sid tell me? I mean, oh, hell, what's the matter? You're here anyway. Oh, look at you. I didn't recognize you. You don't look a bit like your pictures.
Look, I wanted to see you because...
I know, love. And I don't blame you a bit. Must have been a bit of a shock to you finding out about me. I mean, you being a bank manager and everything.
Look, Mrs. Birdsworth, I won't waste your time, as I'm sure you don't want to waste mine. But I want to talk to you for one reason and one reason only. I want to talk about this so-called marriage.
I'm just coming to see you. Any more threats?
No, it seems okay now.
Oh, good. Looks like we frightened them off.
Oh, B reckon she left. I mean...
Who?
Oh, B just had this idea that it could have been
who
somebody...
Who was it?
Well, it could have been anybody.
Kathy, tell me. I can easily check, you know.
Well, the only person who left was Dinah Walford. Oh, look, Terry, let's just forget about it.
Oh, like hell I will. What makes B think it was her?
Well, she was around when I was bashed. And she had a chance to do the jug and the sugar. Now she's gone, everything stopped. It's only a guess.
It's better than nothing.
Look, Terry, just forget about it. I'm not in any danger anymore.
No way. If it was Walford, I want to know why.
Yeah, well, I don't. Just forget about it. It's probably just some crackpot.
Look, I know what I'm doing.
I just want to be left alone.
And you will be, I promise. Now, come on, get going.
Funny sort of place, isn't it?
Do people sleep in there?
I don't really know, darling. I'm sorry I'm in such a mess. I didn't realise you'd be coming so early.
It's all right, love. Great to see you again. Well, isn't it, kids?
Don't I even get a hug from my kids? Oh, I missed my little girl.
Too, Mummy.
Are you too old for a hug?
No.
How was school?
It's all right.
Nothing special to report?
We beat Lakeside on Friday.
That's terrific. Did you play well?
Not bad. Did a couple of goals.
Did you see the game, Don?
No, I had a pretty heavy day.
There's lots of work at the moment?
A bit.
Well, that's good.
You had a bit of a look round as we came in. Some nice gardens. Not too bad a place, really.
Oh, Terry, how about this new film?
What about it?
The film you wanted to see. The critics seem to like it.
Oh, yeah? What night do you want to go?
I thought we were going out tonight.
Yes. Look, I wanted to speak to you about that. Something's come up.
What is it?
Oh, just a bit of business.
Well, why can't you tell me?
Well, I didn't think you'd be interested. Look, we'll go tomorrow night, all right?
Why can't you tell me? Oh, I can be trusted, you know.
Look, I didn't think you'd be interested, but look, I have to do it tonight. Look, tomorrow night, we'll do the whole bit, all right? Dinner, show, supper, what do you think?
Why is this so urgent?
Vera, I can't do it tonight, but we will go out tomorrow night, all right? I've got to go and get Paige.
It's not too bad in here, really.
Food's all right then?
Well, could be better. I've got a room to myself. I might even get to like it.
Sorry, time's up. I suppose we better be going then.
You don't have to go yet. I don't want you to go.
It's all right, love. We'll be back.
I can't stand it in here. You don't know what it's like.
It's all right, no, love. I know. Come on, kids. Say goodbye to your mother and we're going for lunch.
Bye, Mum.
Goodbye, Mummy.
Bye.
Don't forget to sign out before you go, Mr. Page. Come on.
What did you think of the visiting suite?
It was very good.
It's always a bit traumatic the first time.
It was a bit of a strain. Probably because I didn't know what to expect.
I hope you all visit us again.
No doubt about it.
Well, I won't. I hate this place.
Oh, Chris, it wasn't all that bad.
But Mummy was crying.
I know, darling. It's because we had to leave. It'd be much worse if we didn't come back, wouldn't it?
I'll call in and see you all sometime, if that's all right.
I'd appreciate that. Nice to talk to someone who understands. Well, come on, kids. We'll get this lunch.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Well, here she is. Gorge, you're getting a bit exclusive, aren't you?
Yeah, we was wondering where you got to.
Anything wrong, Lizzie?
Nothing. Just want to have a bit of a rest, that's all.
Oh, now, come on. Don't you think we know you better than that?
Yeah. We're wondering where you disappeared to. We saw you nick off with old Barfield.
Was he?
I had a visitor.
Trouble? Oh, now, come on, love. If something's worrying you, why don't you let us help you?
Nothing's worrying me. I just had a visitor.
Who was it, Sid?
No. His son, Gordon.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, coming to check you out, was he? What's he like?
He's a bank manager.
Here we are. Now, listen, kids. We're going to have to be pretty honest with each other.
What's the point?
We're in a bit of a mess, mate. We don't help each other. We've had it. We have to accept what's happened.
It's okay for you, but what about us?
What are you getting at?
Kids at school know about Mum.
That's something we have to accept.
Well, what do you do when they poke fun at you and call your mum a jailbird?
What did you do?
This kid that said that, I belted him.
Oh, it's not the way, Chris. You've got to ignore it. Well, you can't belt everyone.
Mary McClellan's mum told her not to talk to me anymore.
See?
Oh, some people don't understand. You're not a different person because your mother's in jail.
Tell them that.
Daddy, I don't want to go to school anymore. Can't I stay home?
Look, love, I have to go to work. I can't stay at home with you.
Can I come with you?
No, Susie, you have to go to school.
Mum's mucked up my whole life.
I won't have you talking like that, Chris, because it's not true. When your mother comes out, we're going to start again. We're a family. We're going to stick together. You're my family, and I love you. And it includes your mother. Now, are you with me or not?
All right, slow down a bit. Quick stop over there. Here, keep it.
I just want some information.
Oh, look, bugger off. Will you bugger off? You're going to ruin my train.
What do you know about the attacks on Cathy Hall?
Nothing.
Oh, come off it. You were there when it happened. As soon as you left, it stopped. What do you think about that, eh?
You sound just like a cop. What were you doing on the night of the 5th? Oh, you're hurting me.
Yeah. Now, what about Cathy Hall?
I never touched her. What do I care about Cathy Hall?
All right. Do you know who did?
I might.
Well?
I'm a working girl, Mr. Harrison, and I charge for my time.
Yeah, how much?
Depends on what you want.
You know what I want.
Yeah, I think I do.
Another day shift. You're doing all right.
Well, I've tried to stay away from night work since Terry moved in. Well, we're not great socialites, but, well, it's nice to go out sometimes.
Know what you mean. Did you go out last night?
Well, we were supposed to, but Terry had some other business to see to.
Still the happy couple, eh?
Well, yes. Well, it's strange, isn't it? Well, I thought at my age I'd be stuck with a single life. But,
Troubles?
Well, no, it's not that. It's got to do with Hall.
His ex-wife?
He's changed since she appeared.
But they've been separated for ages, haven't they?
Yes, over 10 years. But I think she means more to him than he'll admit. And I don't want that, Meg. I'm not being unreasonable, am I?
No, I don't think you are. Oh, I'm sure everything will work itself out.
So do I. Look, what are you doing tonight?
Nothing, why?
Well, how about coming over to my place for dinner?
Oh, I'd love that. Well, I'll be on my own because Bob's away.
Well, that's fine. 7:30 be all right?
Yes, terrific.
Grace.
Inspector Grace, it's Terry Harrison here.
This Kathy Hall business. I used one of my prison sources and found out who's been threatening her.
A pro by the name of Walford. Dinah Walford.
Walford?
Yeah.
It doesn't ring any bells. Any connections?
Well, I did a bit of after-hours work in the red light district last night.
Really?
Yeah, and that's where I found her. Mind you, she denied knowing anything. Even introduced me to a pimp.
Do you know him?
I thought you might.
He had a very heavy accent. Welsh, I think.
Welsh. Mm. Taffy Bloody Jones.
Yeah, that'd be him. A heavy set bloke. Well, he told me to get lost or he put his boys onto me.
Yeah, well, Taffy and his brother have been connected with McNally's mob for some time. Now, this could be it, Terry.
If you pick up anything else at all, let me know immediately.
Right.
You know, there's one thing that puzzles me through all this. We may know who's after her, but we still don't know why. Now, either she's being a bloody fool by not telling us anything.
Or she's scared.
Yeah. And you can be sure of one thing.
If McNally's involved, we're in for a heavy time.
Why aren't you working, Paige?
I finished, Miss Bennett.
Then you can work in the laundry. They're one short. Stokes has had an accident.
What happened?
Burnt hands.
Miss Bennett, I'd prefer it if I didn't have to work in there.
You're not in here to express preferences. You'll work where you're put.
But they'll get me.
Oh, don't talk rubbish. The sooner you stop all this nonsense, the sooner you'll settle down.
But I can't.
You'll have to. You can't avoid every other prisoner in this place for the next 3 months.
Don't send me in there, Miss Bennett.
Now, Paige, pull yourself together.
Please, Miss
Bennett. Move!
Couldn't we throw rice?
And where are you going to get that from?
Nick it from the kitchen.
Nah, Minnie, you throw it. I know who nicked it.
Oh, yeah.
If you want confetti, you're going to have to cut it up yourself.
Well, I bloody well will, too, even if it means I have to cut up all me comics.
Well, there's self-sacrifice for you.
You all look as if you need some inspiration.
Oh, yeah? What have you got in mind?
Paige here has worked so hard, she's finished all her duties. So I thought she may be able to inspire a bit of industry in here.
I love your fantasies, Vera. They are so romantic.
Just show her what to do.
Oh, certainly. Welcome back to the laundry, Mrs. Paige.
And the rest of you get back to work.
Get over the dryers and unload them.
Do you reckon we'll all be able to go?
Oh, no, the mood Lizzie's in, there mightn't be anything to go to.
God, I wish I knew what that Gordon Humphrey had said to her.
Yeah.
Be nice to have a wedding, though, won't it?
Mind you, it might be a bit low class for some.
Shame about Lil Stokes. She won't be able to go.
Oh, yeah. Fancy burning her hand like that. Nasty accident.
Dangerous place, prisons.
Yeah.
You can say that again.
Hey, has someone had another go at you?
Not yet, but I'm always looking over my shoulder.
Oh, you'll be all right. I reckon if anyone was going to knock you off in here, they would have done it by now.
Yeah. I still say it was Dinah Walford. There's no other explanation.
I hope you're right. The trouble is Terry's sticking his nose in. He's probably coming the heavy with her on the outside.
And how does he know about it?
He conned it out of me.
Well, that wouldn't be hard, would it? Look, the less he knows about it, the better. Because if he starts stirring up trouble on the outside, whoever sent Dinah in will send someone else in after you.
Oh, God, I couldn't go through that again.
Then keep your trap shut. Because next time it may not just be a rewired jug. They might just do the job properly.
Yeah, wouldn't be the first time.
No.
Oh, have I said something really positively dreadful?
Boy, I don't know. Just started work, more or less, and I've had it already.
I suppose that means you don't want to go out tonight again.
Well, no, it doesn't mean that. Well, no, I don't want to go out, but not because I'm tired. There's something I want to talk over with you.
Well, you'll have to talk it over with Meg as well. I've invited her for dinner.
What do you do that for? I might have bought theatre tickets on the way into work.
Let's just say that I had a feeling. Anyway, apart from Meg being my best friend, we owe her a dinner.
Yeah, it's a bit of a nuisance, that's all.
Why? You like her, don't you?
Yeah, well, of course I like her. Look, you don't understand, love, what I had to say. Well, it's important.
Going out last night was important to me.
Damn it, Vera, you're not making this any easier for me. We have to be alone tonight.
What are you talking about? Why?
Why? Because I was going to ask you to marry me, that's why. Well, will you?
Oh,
Nightmare.